What's up, everyone? I'm Heather Young, sponsored by Prodigy Disc and Flight Factory Discs, and I'm here to show you what's in my bag. I'll start with my putters. I putt with PA3s. Right now I'm using the Chris Dickerson Signature Series ones. They feel like they have a slightly bigger bead to me, and I just like that feel. But these have done me well over the year, and I'm really liking them. For throwing putters, I have two different molds in my bag right now. The first one is the new PX3. I'm really liking the stiffness of the plastic. It lets me have a clean release on sidearms, and then it still feels good for backhands. And then the other one that's new to my bag this year is a P Model US. I always struggled with like kind of holding on to approaches too long, but this with the shallower profile really lets me get a clean release on it and have touch within like 100 feet, but it can also hold up to power for longer throws. Next is A3s, sort of in between a putter and a mid. I will throw these backhand sometimes, but I really like them for sidearm approaches. I have two different ones. They're very similar. This one's just older and it's much straighter now, so I can flick it hard and it pretty much just holds straight with a slight finish. This one is really overstable still, so I know that it'll come back no matter what, even in the wind. Next up, I only have two mids. They're both M3s. I really like the Huck Lab stamp. Thank you, Jarrett Nesmith, for this one. This has done me well over the year. This one has gotten understable now, so it's really nice for like turnover shots or things like that. And then this one is pretty straight now, a little bit of stability at the end. So it's just nice for like any hyzer shots or flex shots with a mid. For fairway drivers, I have two different molds in my bag, an F2. This one's really beat in now. It's also a little bit lighter weight than some. So I really like it for like hyzer flip shots, but it just goes straight and then finishes. And then for like hyzer flip to turnovers or just long turnovers, I have two different F5s. This one is really good for like long turnovers, but I also use it as a roller now. And then this one still has some stability, so I can hyzer flip it and get a finish or just throw it on Annie and get a long turnover. For overstable fairways, I have an FX2. Thank you, Chris, for this one. It's gotten understable now to where I can throw it. I really like this one sidearm. I can throw it on a hyzer and it flips up and goes straight. Or if I throw it backhand, it has a nice flex. And then an H1 V2, this is just overstable. Any shot that I need something overstable, it will go right for me since I'm lefty. For drivers, I don't have too many molds in my bag. For like max distance or like in a tailwind, I have an Air D1. It's very understable and it's also lightweight, so I can just throw it high on an Annie and just let it hold the whole way and come back. And then after that, I have 4D2s, all different stabilities. This one is my flippiest one. I can throw it flat and it will turn. If I throw it on Annie, it'll just hold, which is nice for a driver. Then this one's my utility disc all around. This is what I'm throwing 90% of the time. It's overstable, but it flips up, so it gives me more distance. And then these two are very similar. One's a Core Team D2, one's a Thomas Gilbert D2. They're both very overstable. It's just which I like for the feel. I like this one better for sidearms, this one better for backhands. So yeah, it just really depends on the feel for me. I can throw most of them and make them work for any shot, but I'm kind of picky on what I like of the feel of things. But yeah, that's my in the bag.